serious?
Sorry, man.
Come on, dude.
Gosh,
man. Hey, you.
Oh, me?
Yeah, you.
God?
No. Are you still not making the volleyball team?
Yeah.
Are the kids still making fun of you for it?
Yep.
Then exercising for volleyball players is a video for you.
Heads up, loser.
Guys, this is exercising for volleyball players, and it's going to help you out with your vertical, footwork, and endurance. And this can be done 3-4 times a week. And let's get started. All right, guys, so for our warm-up, we're going to be doing 15 seconds of high knees. And let's go ahead and get started, guys. And try bringing those knees all the way up. Get our bodies warm for this workout. There we go, keep it going. 5 more seconds. And time. Now we're gonna be doing 15 seconds of butt kicks, and let's get that going. And for this one, try to just literally kick your butt. I'm trying to fully extend so that your quads get warm. 5 more seconds here. And time. Alright, so for the next thing for our warm-up, we're going to do flamingos, 15 seconds each side. Alright, let's start off with our right leg, guys. And try to keep those knees as close as possible. And bring that foot as far back as possible so that we really feel that stretch in our quad. And 5 more seconds here. And go ahead and switch to the left leg. So for the next exercise, we're going to do some Frankensteins. And for this exercise, we want to keep our spine as neutral as possible and with the leg as straight as possible. And if you can touch your toes, it's fine. If you can't, that's cool as well. And we're going to start off with one leg before we switch to the other. 7 reps on each side. Start off with our left leg. There you go. Go ahead and switch. And the next warm-up is going to be the single leg kickback. And for this one, we want to focus on keeping our shoulders in line with our pelvis and our spine. And just make sure that we keep the leg straight and really feel it in your hamstrings. And we're going to go 10 of these on each one, alternate between 5 on each leg. And if you can't touch the floor, that's totally fine. Just make sure you focus on form here. Some lunges here. We're gonna go 3 forward on each leg and then 3 backward on each leg, and really just try to keep your leg straight and prevent that back knee from touching the floor. And we're gonna start off on our left leg here. And let's get that going. And switch legs. And as you can see, Christian's back knee is not touching the floor. He's keeping the lower leg as straight as possible. Go ahead and switch to backward. There we go, same exact principle here, guys. Want to prevent any injuries to the knees. Go, 2 more. Alright, guys, now we're going to do some side lunges. We're going to go for a 5-second hold on each leg, and we're going to go a total of 2 rounds. And as you can see, Natalie's keeping her opposite leg as straight as possible. She's preventing her knees from going over the toes. again, we want to prevent her from having a knee injury. Now we're going to do some arm circles and some ankle rolls here. Let's start off with our right ankle, and we're going to go for 10 seconds on each leg. Five more seconds, guys. And switch to your left ankle, and we're gonna go backwards on these arm circles here. And five more seconds. And time. Okay, so for this exercise, we're gonna do an air squat. So let's get going. One, two, make sure you just throw your butt back there and your knees don't go past your toes. Six, seven, eight, and on the last one, we're just hold it for 15 seconds. Nine, 10, and hold. I really feel that burn. Make sure your knees do not go over your toes. A little bit longer. Ooh, this is a nice burn. Five, four, three, two, one. Okay, so for our next workout, we're gonna be doing proprioceptive plyometrics. And for this workout, we're gonna need a line. So let's go. For these plyometrics, we're just gonna be jumping over this line front and back for 20 seconds. Okay, ready? Go. Make sure you guys really move your arms too, it helps out. And go as fast as you can. Come on, keep going. 10 more seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, so for this next one, we're gonna be doing the same thing, but instead we're just gonna be hopping side to side over the line for 20 seconds. Okay, ready? Ready, go. Swing your arms again too. Get your arms going. Go as fast as you can. Come on. Go fast. Less than 10 seconds. Come on. 2, 1. Stop. Okay, so let's take a 30 second break.
So now we're going to go into jump squats, like the normal air squats we were doing, except we're going to add a jump at the end of it. So we're going to do 10 of these. Let's go. Really focus on that landing. You're landing on the balls of your feet. Got two more. Okay, now we're gonna go back into plyometrics, so we're gonna go back to the lines we had before. Let's go. Okay, now we're gonna be doing the same thing as we did before on our lines, except now we're gonna be jumping on one leg. So we're gonna start off with the right leg, front and back, and we're gonna go for 10 seconds. Let's go. Try to keep those arms moving and land on the ball of your feet. 2 seconds. Okay, now left foot, let's go. 3 more seconds. Okay, now we're gonna go side to side, starting with our right foot, 10 seconds again, and let's go. Okay, now left leg, side to side. Take a 20 second break.
Okay, so for this exercise, we're doing knee ups. So we're gonna start on our knees. Your knees could be maybe shoulder width apart, or you could go even narrower. For an easier version of this, you could look at Natalie. And then for a harder or just a normal version of this, you could just look at Jericho and I. For the easier version, Natalie's just gonna go step, step, and then jump. But what we're doing, we're gonna jump and then jump again. Okay. We're gonna do 7 of these. Okay, so ready, guys? Let's go. 1, 2. For these, you can go a little bit at your own pace. 4, 5, 6. Come on, one more. 7. Okay, so for this next exercise, we're doing calf raises. For an easier version, you can look at Natalie. She's gonna do a double leg calf raise for 30 reps, and Jericho and I are gonna do single leg calf raises for 15 reps. Go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Now switch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15.
Okay, now we're gonna go into Super Mario lunges. And so how to do these, you're gonna start off with a back lunge, and then you're gonna jump at the top and land on their front foot. And so if the jumping is too hard for you, you can follow Christian, and he's just gonna bring his leg up and no jump. Then for the regular version, you can just follow me and Jericho. We're gonna do 10 of these per leg. So let's start with the left leg on the ground. Make sure your knee is not protruding over your toe. Go 2 more. Okay, now we're gonna go put the right leg on the ground and really focus on that soft landing on the ball of your foot. Okay, so now we're gonna go into ice skaters, and we're gonna do a total of 10, so 5 per leg. We're gonna start by jumping to the right. Go here. Really have that soft landing on the ball of your feet. You can move your arms to keep your balance. Two more. Great job. Okay guys, that's it for the workout. Now we're gonna go into a cool down.
All right guys, so for our first exercise, we're gonna be doing a calf stretch, and we're gonna go 30 second hold on each leg. And let's start off with our right leg here. And just try not to be hunched over so that our back doesn't get too activated in the stretch. Just try to get that connection on the calf muscle. We're about halfway here. And 5 more seconds. And time. Go ahead and switch, guys. And really try to push down with the leg that you're focusing on, so just so that you feel that stretch in that Achilles tendon, that calf. About halfway. And 5 more seconds.
for this next stretch here, we're going to be doing the hurdler stretch, and we're going to start off with our left leg. And same thing as always, 30 seconds each. And try to go as low as possible. If you can touch your toes, that's great. Just really focus on stretching out that hamstring as well. And we're about halfway, guys. Time. Go ahead and switch to the right leg. And time.
Okay, for this next stretch, you're gonna go and you're gonna have your left leg out and you're gonna go up on your hands and then have your right leg bent in front of you. And you want your foot to kind of be in the middle between your shoulders, and you want, you can use your right elbow to push the leg that's bent out so you can really feel the tension in the groin area and your hamstrings. And you're gonna hold this for 30 seconds. Crossed over and really feel the stretch in your hamstring. And again, hold for 30 seconds. Okay, now we're gonna go to the other side. You're gonna have now your right leg out behind you, and then your left leg bent. Just use your left arm to push your knee out to really feel the stretch more. And then go for 30 seconds. Again, your left leg crossed over your right, reach across. Halfway there.
Okay, so for our last stretch, we're just gonna do a simple butterfly.
So what we're gonna do is we're gonna sit on our butts, bring our feet to our groin areas, really bend our knees, and really feel the stretch in your groin area. Also try pulling your feet towards you. You'll feel a better stretch with this. Fifteen more seconds. I like this stretch a lot. It's a nice stretch. And stop. Okay, so you want to do the following exercises maybe 3-4 times a week. This will really help you with your athletic performance. It'll really help with your stamina and really help with your footwork. And hopefully you can make the volleyball team next season. So yeah, good luck and thanks for watching.